Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see in a short time all the main and basic features you need to know to start using Premiere Elements 2018 as a beginner. Write a comment inside the video description below to improve our next video guides for this software. Premiere Elements is one of the best video editing solutions for both beginners and experts. In order to create customized videos and slideshows with a simple and direct interface. In respect to Premiere Pro CC, this does not require a subscription plan at all. When you open Premiere Elements, a dialog box opens, showing the three main products inside Adobe Elements 2018. Photo Editor opens Photoshop Elements 2018, used to correct and adjust your favorite photos. Organizer opens Elements Organizer 2018 to manage and collect your media inside albums and collections. Video Editor opens Premiere Elements 2018. Check out our full guide link in the video description to learn more about Photoshop Elements and Organizer. Premiere Elements has four different workspaces, all listed on top. The eLife page shows all the latest news, updates, and tutorials from Adobe. The Quick Workspace is used to create your own video by using a simple storyboard view. The Guided Workspace lists several adjustments and professional tools you can apply to your media. And the Expert Workspace is used to create your own videos through a professional interface that uses audio and video tracks instead of storyboards. In this video, we will see the Quick and Guided Workspaces. If you want to know more about the Expert one, check out our related videos in this guide. The Quick Workspace is divided in several parts, such as the main preview, the project timeline below, and several useful tools on the extreme right. With Premiere Elements, you can create your videos in two ways, by using guided and ready templates with the Create button, or make customized videos with all the features inside the software. In this video, we will show you how to create your own video on your own. To start editing, you have to import all the necessary media, such as video, pictures, and audio files. You can go to Add Media in the top left corner to import your files from Adobe Organizer, from any camera or webcam, or from your own computer folders and hard drives. You can also import media by dragging and dropping it directly from your folders to the project timeline. All imported media are collected inside the several rows or tracks inside the project timeline. The title tracks on top is used to import any text. The main video track collects all videos and pictures, and the two audio tracks at the bottom are used to add any speech recording or music. Each file imported is shown as a small rectangle called clip. The basic idea of using storyboards inside the timeline is made to create videos by simply collecting a sequence of clips in time, one after another. You can use the main preview to check the timeline content you made exactly where the red playhead is placed. You can click on the gray line above to place it and check a particular instant in time. You can also click and drag the playhead to check your project frame after frame in time. Whereas to play back your video, use the player right below the preview. Now let's see how to edit and adjust your media inside the timeline. Use the zoom bar on the right to zoom in and out the timeline content. You can change the order of the clips by clicking and dragging one before or after another clip in time. If you right-click on a clip, you can cut, copy, delete, and rotate it by 90 degrees. If you make any mistake, you can undo and redo your past actions made by using the undo and redo buttons at the bottom. To split a clip in two independent pieces, fix the red playhead properly, and then click on the scissors button close to it. Whereas to trim clips in time, you can click and drag from their edges and shorten them as needed. Trimmed clips will show a small icon on a corner, indicating the part of the clip content has been cut. Pay attention that you can't stretch video or audio clips over their original duration and time. Audio clips can be stretched and remixed to fit the new duration and time. You can also use the preview to edit the size of your clips. When you click on a clip, you will select it. This will be highlighted in blue color. At this point, if you click on the preview, you can apply some quick editing on the clip itself. For example, you can move the clip by clicking and dragging it, scale it by using the blue nodes, and rotate it by dragging from outside. You can fix the rotation point by moving the anchor point. Premiere Elements has advanced features and tools to make your video special and professional, all collected inside the toolbar on the right, and divided in several sections, such as Fix to adjust the clips, Edit to modify clips and apply effects, and Add to insert extra content. Let's take a look. The Fix section is made by adjustments and tools. The adjustments apply quick corrections on the clip that is selected from the timeline. If you select a picture, you will get all video adjustments. If you select audio, you will get corrections for volume and stereo balance. If you select videos, you will get both video and audio adjustments. Some of these adjustments are made automatically. For example, if you go to Smart Fix, you just have to click on Apply to make corrections. Other video adjustments, such as color, lighting, and temperature and tint, provide several templates ready to use that you can apply by clicking on one. If you want to apply custom adjustments, just click on More below. As for sound adjustments, you can correct volume and balance by using the bars you see. When you apply adjustments or effects on clip, these will show a small FX icon in a corner. All adjustments applied show a green circle on the right. If you do not like a correction, you can disable it by using the eye icon, or remove it definitely by clicking on Reset. You can also apply visual adjustments on the entire project and not on single clips by enabling the Entire Movie button on top. Beside the adjustments, you have the tools for the most advanced corrections for your clip, each with their own guided interface. Check them out. The Edit section collects all the visual effects available inside Premiere Elements. The first button opens the Applied Effects panel, which lists all the effects applied on the clip selected from the timeline. The second button opens the Effects panel, with all the visual effects available depending on the category chosen on top. And the third button opens the Transitions panel, which are special effects used to make clips appear and disappear. By default, all visual clips, such as pictures and videos, have two effects not removable, such as motion and opacity. Motion collects all the basic properties of the clip, such as position, scaling, and rotation. Opacity sets its transparency level instead. Besides these, you can add other effects to the clip by dragging and dropping another one from the Effects panel. This will be listed in the Applied Effects panel, with its own options and settings you can change. All these effects are applied by following the list from top to bottom. If you change this order, the final appearance of the clip may also change according to it. You can move an effect up or down by clicking and dragging it. Besides each effect, you have several useful icons. The eye icon enables and disables the effect. The Reset button resets the effect settings, and the Bin button removes the effect from the list. Transitions are special effects that make clips appear and disappear. Choose a transition from its panel and drag and drop it at the beginning or the ending part of a clip, or between two clips. Then, set its duration and check its effect on the preview. The added transition is indicated through its small icon in a corner. You can edit its settings again by double-clicking on it. To change the effect of the transition, just drop another on its icon. The Add section collects everything to add extra content, such as titles, music samples, and visual graphics, that you can pick and drop directly on your timeline tracks. Let's see all the titles in detail. Inside Premiere Elements, you have two main text templates, the classic titles and the motion titles, selectable from the list on the top of the titles panel. Classic titles are simple pieces of text that can have animation and basic geometrical shapes inside. Type directly on the preview and use the Adjustments palette to set the text font, style, size, distribution, and color. Under Animation, choose your favorite animation and click on the Apply button to add it. Under Shapes, choose your favorite shape, its color, and draw it on the preview. Each of these elements can be edited by holding Ctrl down in order to move, scale, and rotate them. Motion titles are complex title templates made by text content, visual shapes called graphics, and the overall background, which can be different from the timeline clip themselves. You can move and scale these directly on the preview and use the Adjustments palette to manage the appearance of the elements you have selected from the preview. So the text style and any animations under text, the visual appearance of the shapes under graphics, and the image background and its opacity under background. For more amazing and professional tools, you can use the Guided Workspace. This lists several video and audio adjustments you can apply to your media step by step by using either the Quick or the Expert Workspace. Check it out. When your video is ready, save and render it. To save your project, go to File and then go to Save As. This will save your project as a .prel file format, collecting any of your media, settings, and adjustments applied on each of them. To play back and upload the final video of your project, you have to render it. To do so, go to Export and Share in the top right corner. Its dialog box shows several options in order to choose the correct settings depending on the destination. Under Quick Export, you can render your video to your computer with a standard .mp4 file format. Under Devices, you can render your video with the best settings for either your computer, TV, or mobile device, choosing resolution, format, and quality. Under Disk, you can burn your video to any disk. Under Online, you can render and upload your video on YouTube, Facebook, or Vimeo with a resolution up to HD 1080p. Choose Audio to render the audio part of the project. An Image to save a single frame of your project or a GIF file on it. Once you have fixed the setup, choose the file name, the destination folder below, and then go to Save to start rendering. Thanks for watching this video. Check out the following video in this guide to discover more about Expert Workspace inside Premiere Elements 2018.